Dolly Parton, Christmas at Home. Starring Dolly Parton, her family, and friends.
Oh, you know, this is one of the happiest places in the whole world. I just love it because it's always Christmas in here. Look at all these things, and look at that. Ain't that cute with the little glasses? All the little ones would love that. You want to go home with me? Oh, and look at the carousel. That's great. Hey, that reminds me. I want to remember to take all the kids on a carousel ride while I'm here. But you know, we never did call it a carousel when I was growing up. It was always just a merry-go-round. Well, hi. What are you doing? Is that your train?
No.
It's not. Are you going to buy that for Christmas?
Yeah.
Well, maybe Santa will bring it to you. You have a Merry Christmas, okay?
Yeah.
Listen, I think I hear me singing. Is that me?
Sure is. We just got it in.
Well, you know what? We had to start recording that back in July in order to get that record out for Christmas.
How in the world do you get in the mood to do Christmas music in July?
Oh, Christmas is a state of mind. You just kind of throw yourself into the spirit, and it can happen almost any time. Besides that, I had a lot of help on this one.
On a cold winter's night, that was...
Hey, this looks great!
Hey.
The Mighty Fine Band had their own little elves, Ellen and Mark and Larry and Dawn and Judy. I know the rest of you, but you might have thought of it. It's great. Now, this puts us in the spirit. I want you to know, though, we have a camera here today, so I don't want any of you guys cussing, okay? Well, I mean, if you do, don't do it while I'm saying something cute, because I don't want it to get cut out.
It'll be nice.
You'll be nice? Okay. Do we want to do something?
Yeah, let's do a little bit of I'll Be Home for Christmas.
Good one.
Oh, I'm going to get homesick and start thinking about the Smokies. Well, if I cry, play loud.
Because your mama will be colder than the North Pole when we get there.
Well, I'm going to warm her up, though. I got some great stuff.
Oh, great.
Well, Daddy's looking real good. I can't wait to see Mama and all the nieces and nephews and see how much they've grown. And my sisters and brothers. I sure miss messing around with them. They know how to keep me humble. I love to be with Mom and Daddy and just kind of become a kid again for a little while. You know, just about everybody in these parts is related to us one way or another. And when we all get together, as we try to do every Christmas, it's really something to see. And I want everybody to see them and to love them the way I do, because they're real special people. I just wish it had snowed. We're coming up on the house now.
Things
to my Tennessee mountain home. This is the old home place. Still looks pretty much like it did then on the outside, but I have made a few improvements on the inside. As you can see, I've decorated it with wall-to-wall partings.
Hey! Who's here? Well, hello, ho, ho! Mama!
All right, I love you, Dolly.
I love you. Merry Christmas. Hey, take these presents and put them under the tree. Hi. How's everybody? Hi, Hannah. How you doing, Tiber? Well, Merry Christmas to you. Hi, Teddle.
Randy's got a song
Dolly.
For you.
Hey, y'all be quiet. We wrote you a song for Christmas.
You did?
Yeah.
Well, this I can't wait to hear. That's nice.
We all love our sister Dolly. Fa la 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 la. Cause she looks like Grandma's collie. Fa la 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 la.
That's real cute. I really like that. Mm-hmm. I traveled afar just to hear that.
How far did you travel?
You better have something better than that or you're off the show.
We got more.
You got more? It better be better.
Since it is the Christmas season, fa la 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 la. Hope she knows we're only teasing.
That's better. I feel better now.
Merry Christmas.
This is my brother Randy. He's a real funny guy, yeah. I tell you what, now that you've had your little fun, why don't we really sing this song for real? All of us.
For more of Dolly with family and friends.
At Christmas time when I was a kid, I always loved the story about the three wise men. I used to always picture them as being like Dr. Thomas. He was the only doctor that we had up here in these hills, and he used to ride the ridges on horseback taking care of the sick. He was a well-educated man, and he could have made a fine living somewhere else, but he loved these people, and he loved the mountains. Most of the folks up here just paid him with a live chicken or a sack of cornmeal. He delivered me. He was our preacher, too, so years later, he tried to deliver me from sin. Of course, that was a much harder job for him. He's gone now, but what he brought to these mountains was a much greater gift than gold or frankincense.
Far field and fountain, moor and mountain, following yonder star. Born a king on Bethlehem's plain, gold I bring to crown him again, king forever. Frankincense and myrrh of love and sacrifice, prayer and praising all men, raising worship Him, God Most High. Oh, oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light. Westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy kings of Orient are bearing gifts, we traverse afar. We three kings.
Who is having too much fun in here? Sounds like somebody's making cookies. This is a good kitchen for it. You know, this is the kitchen my grandma used to make gravy and biscuits in for me when I was your age. And that is the same microwave oven that my great-great-grandma brought with her from England.
It's not.
It is, too. And don't you eat all that dough. You gotta save some for cookies. Hey, look what Vanessa and Jade has made. It's a map of North Carolina. It's not a map of North Carolina. What is it supposed to be? That's right. Why don't we sing that while you put a big red nose on? Do you want to help me sing?
No.
Well, do it anyway. This is a television show. What do you mean, no? You're going to help me sing when we get there? Huh? You will, won't you? You know the song?
Yeah.
Okay, well, I bet you all so know Dasher and Dancer and Prancer and Vixen and Comet, was it, and Cupid and Donner and Blitzen. But do you know the most famous reindeer of all? Old red nose that everybody made fun of except Santa. You want to sing?
Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer had a very shiny nose, and if you ever saw it, you would say it glows. All of the other reindeers used to laugh and call him names. They wouldn't run for Rudolph, joining any reindeer games. Then
watch out.
Shouted out with glee, Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer, you'll go down in history. Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer, you'll go down in history.
Yay! Yeah! That's good.
Oh, thank you.
I got a cookie for you.
Well, thank you.
Got some for Mama? Thank you.
Thank you.
Mine was green.
Oh, well, what you got there? Cookies, and I bet you I know what's in that. I bet everybody in this house knows what's in that box.
I bet you had chocolate-covered cherries now.
I bet you're right. You know what?
51 of them.
51 boxes.
51.
See, now, we all know the story, but Brian and some of these young ones don't know that. Mama, won't you tell Brian and all these big kids the story?
All the big ones and little
ones. The little ones.
Well, we were very young and didn't have much money when we married 51 years ago. So I had a dollar on Christmas. I bought a box of cherry candy and a handkerchief, wrapped it, gave it to Lee. And every year since, I've gave him that. So in later years, your kid looks close for that, you go looking under the tree to see if Daddy's candies are. As long as I live, it'll always be there.
Well, that's not... We usually get to eat the candy. Daddy just likes to get it because it's romantic. Well, what did he get you?
12 beautiful children, 6 boys and 6 girls.
Oh, let's say thank you, Mama.
Thank you, Mama. Thank you, Daddy.
That's real sweet. Did you want to add anything to Mama's story about that?
I believe she just about covered all of it,
Dolly. Oh, she usually does. She usually does most of the talking, don't she? That's real sweet. Well, I just want to take the time, since it is Christmas, from all of us to thank you both for all the good years that you've given us, and thank you for sharing that story and your candy.
And speaking of stories, we've got a story on you.
Another story about me. Did Randy help you with this? Is this like one of Randy's songs?
Do you remember what Dolly always wanted for Christmas?
Makeup!
She'd rather had makeup than live.
Daddy wouldn't allow it in the house.
He said it was evil.
But you know how Dolly was. She used to take matches and burn them and wet them on the ends and make mascara.
Yeah, and I remember how I used to take them old pokeberries used to grow out and back and put them on my lips and pinch my cheeks till they just was pink and they were beautiful till they turned blue. But that didn't stop me either.
Then Daddy would ask you if you were wearing makeup and you would just lie.
I didn't just lie.
I wasn't wearing makeup. I was wearing pokeberries. I better sing. You better help me. And you better watch me.
Still we see thee lie above thy deep and dreamless sleep. The silent stars go by, yet in the dark streets shine up the everlasting light. The hopes and fears of all the years are
Christmas love and laughter coming right up.
Okay, kids, let's load up the wagon. And those of you carrying cookies, don't eat them. They go to some special people. I'm checking for cookie breath later. Everybody up. Hit it there, Jennifer.
Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in one horse open sleigh. Hey, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh. O'er the fields we go, laughing all the way. Bells on bobtail ring, making spirits bright. What fun it is to ride and sing a sleighing song tonight. Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle.
Visit, live at the Sevier County Nursing Home. I think just seeing all these cute kids will brighten their day even more than these cookies. Everybody ready?
Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a
wonderful people here, and this special little lady in the white shawl is my best friend Judy's mother, Blanche Ogle. Here's a cookie.
How sweet. A cookie in the shape of North Carolina.
It's Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
Oh, mercy. Of course it is. How silly of me not to know it.
Hey, Merry Christmas, everybody! How you doing? Merry Christmas.
Hi, Dolly.
Hello, Elwood. I take it you've met old Elwood, our silly hillbilly from Dollywood. Well, we just came by to bring these folks some Christmas cheer.
Oh, Dolly, I tell you, it's so good to get you home for Christmas, and you've all been so sweet to us that Chuck and the band, they've been rehearsing the Christmas number called Ring Them Bells.
Oh, really?
And they want to play it for you before they take it out on the road.
Well, that sounds good. We'd like to hear it.
Yeah,
you just do it,
play.
Me and the kids will enjoy
Chuck.
Ourselves.
Ring the bells, ring the bells, let the whole world know. Christ was born in Bethlehem many years ago.
When we think of Christmas, we think mostly of the children, but the holiday has meaning for older people as well. When I was real young, I knew most of these folks who are with us today. They were about the age I am now. And before too long, I'll probably be their age, and these young'uns will be my age. That's why I want these kids to experience this day and to remember the closeness they feel with these fine people. I want them to know that folks in their golden years can still enjoy the things we all enjoy and still appreciate the true gifts of life, like music and friendship and having someone care about you. Yes, Christmas is a holiday for all ages.
Christ the Savior lived today as He did so long ago.
Hey! Woohoo! Very good! Boy, I tell you, I thought I had a good band.
Well, thank you.
I believe this is just as good. We call ours the Mighty Fine Band. I believe you're just as fine.
Well, thank you.
I want to wish all of you a Merry Christmas. I got a whole batch of kids here that I'm going to take over to the park to ride on the carousel. So if you get tired of picking and a singing, come over and join us.
Well, thank you.
Okay,
we'll
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you, Chuck. Let's go.
We wish you a
here we go.
Christmas.
Let's see that there.
We wish you a Merry Christmas.
You'd enjoy all them ugly cookies we all had so much fun making. It was fun. You know what else? You ladies need to come up and join us in our church service. We got Bobby Jones and the best gospel choir out of Nashville joining us. Would you join?
Sure thing. We'll see you there.
We'll look forward to it. Next stop, Dollywood. You know, there is a rumor that there is a gentleman with a white beard and a red suit that's in the area, so I would suggest that you kids kind of be on your best behavior.
Do you mean Santa Claus?
Well, I'm talking about that list-making, note-taking, white-bearded, red-coated, pot-bellied chimney crawler. And if that don't sound like Santa Claus to you, I don't know what does. You ready to go? Time's a-wasting. Hit it, Bobby. Let's go!
Carousels and Christmas bells and lots more joy coming up with Dolly and her family.
Hey, everybody, jump up on that carousel. I promised you a ride. And I keep my promises. Find you one, Danielle. Hi, T-Rex. I noticed it didn't take you long to find one. Did you know that this old carousel is almost 100 years old? That means for over 100 years, the kids just like you have been enjoying this ride. You know what else they say? That wherever you find children, Santa Claus is nearby. Now, he knows if you've been behaving or if you've been misbehaving. He may be somewhere out there now. I know some of you wonder if he knows every little thing you do. Well, he might. Maybe so, maybe no, but you better watch out.
You better not cry, you better not pout, I'm telling you why. Santa Claus coming to town. And he's making a list and checking it twice. Gonna find out who's naughty or nice. Santa Claus is coming to town. Is coming to town. Oh, and he's gonna fiddle around. Oh, Santa.
Santa Claus is coming to town.
He sees you when you're sleeping. He knows if you're is coming, yes, Santa Claus is coming. Oh, Santa Claus is coming to town.
Hey, look, here he comes now. Hey, Santa. Oh, it is so good to see you.
Well, it's good to see you too, Dolly.
Oh, you know, I know a lot of my Christmas wishes haven't changed since I was a kid. You know, I remember when I was young, I used to make out my Christmas list, and then after Christmas, I never could find the list.
Does this look familiar, Dolly?
Oh, Santa, I recognize that. It says, Dear Santa, if it's okay with you, I'd like my mom and dad to be healthy and happy. I'd like all my brothers and sisters to be blessed with the spirit of Christmas. And I'd like all the children of the world to be able to live in peace without fear. And if I could have that, then you don't have to bring me anything else for myself. And you know what, Santa? I still have that same Christmas wish today, so this would be all I want again.
I'll see what I can do, Dolly.
Well, maybe I'd like to have some of those big old double fudge brownies that weigh about a pound and a half a piece. Yeah. Now, of course, I wouldn't buy that for myself anymore, but if Santa brought it, well, I wouldn't turn it down, if you know what I mean.
Right.
Thank you, Santa.
Bye, Dolly.
Bye-bye. And what are you making there, Lee?
A Santa Claus.
Really? I just left Santa Claus.
You did?
He didn't look a thing like that.
Well, this is a Saint Nick.
Kind of pale, ain't he?
Yeah.
He'll look better soon, though.
Yeah, he will.
Especially with our Dolly wood carver.
That's right.
You know, here in the Smoky Mountains, we didn't have shopping malls or big department stores to go Christmas shopping in. And even if we did, most of us couldn't have afforded to go anyway because money was kind of tight. So what we learned to do was to give each other gifts that we made with our own two hands. Like this special man right here. Now, when he asks, do you want a belt for Christmas? He ain't talking about eggnog, right? Merry Christmas to you. You got some pretty things there. You know, there's a long tradition of giving gifts with special meaning at Christmas time, and I guess it goes back to the very first Christmas when the wise men came from the East bringing gifts to honor the Christ child. But even then, they tell us that the gifts that were the most pleasing in the eyes of God were the ones given with love and devotion, regardless of the cost. That's a sweet sound. The best of chimes. Oh, and there's a good-looking man just working away. Now, I bet you this is where the saying, one good turn deserves another, comes from, right?
That's right.
I'm trying to be funny here at Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Nice to see you. Merry Christmas to you. Oh, and there's a sweet sound coming out of that little shop. This is the dulcimer shop. They say that the dulcimer is the angel of stringed instruments. It is angelic, ain't it? Even in the hands of two devils like these. Just joking, guys. Merry Christmas to you. Oh, and there's the old sawmill. Nobody's working that today, don't look like. I know you girls ain't working at the sawmill. Merry Christmas to you. Nice to see you. They're really looking for those good-looking men up there in Craftsman's Valley. Now, over here is a shop that's kind of special to me. You know, they tell women that they look great by candlelight. That's what we tell them here at this shop. You'd be surprised how many candles we sell because of that.
That's right.
You do look good by candlelight,
Thank
though.
Thank you.
Working on you.
Merry Christmas, darling.
Merry Christmas. Oh, I hear a special sound. There's a special boy, too. On our Christmas show, this too is a family affair. All the folks in the nativity scene, the shepherds and kings and angels, Mary and Joseph, they're all played by relatives and close friends of ours. Even our little drummer boy, Jason, is family. Oh, and he wanted to play this part so bad, I just couldn't say no. I'm just happy to see he got his Christmas wish. On my drum.
Christmas carols coming up next with Dolly, her family, and friends.
Whether the snow is real or manufactured, there's nothing artificial about the joy and pleasure we feel here in the Smoky Mountains about Christmas. We're heading for the church to share in the spirit of the holiday season. There's fellowship, fine music, soft and spirited singing, and we're saving you a seat right up front. Heart. You know, the good book says, make a joyful noise unto the Lord. And I don't know of a better time or a better place to do it than right here, right now. So join me in song and let's just raise these old rafters as high as they can go.
Joy to the world. The Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room.
And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing.
And heaven and heaven and nature sing. Joy to the world, the Savior reigns.
resounding joy. Repeat, repeat the sounding joy. Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room.
And heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing,
and heaven and heaven and
nature sing.
This next song reminds me of the simplicity of the mountains and the simplicity of that first Christmas.
The first Noel, the angel did say, was to certain poor shepherds in fields as they lay.
In fields where and everywhere, go tell it on the mountain.
Have changed, but not my memories. And no matter where I am at Christmas, my heart is always home. Merry Christmas, everybody, and may God always bless you.